Now, in Road to IELTS reading session, we are looking at practice test 5 of GT, that is General Training Module. So, we have already seen various practice tests, so you are aware of these instructions. Section 1, we'll start with section 1. Need to read the text below and answer questions. So, BPA, the Backpackers Alliance, the leading hostel network for independent travelers. What is BPA? It is the largest group of backpackers style accommodation providers in the state, and these are state owned and operated, so they all meet rigid criteria for health and safety. BPA accommodation, we have over 200 listing to give you the best chance of finding the most suitable accommodation where you are most likely to enjoy, and that could be in the mountains, by the sea, in the bush, and in the center of bustling city, almost anywhere in the state. BPA prices are always the lowest. Order your BPA accommodation guide now and check it out. What about membership? Join BPA and enjoy the benefits of registration, which includes access to a variety of popular options. BPA online bookings, secure telephone bookings, you will not need to risk giving out your credit card details over the phone. Rating details, 1 to 4 stars on all BPC accommodation. You'll also receive your BPA club card, which gives you preferential regular user rates. Once you have used our service 10 times, you become a loyal customer and enjoy an 8% discount on all bookings. $5 repaid on all online bookings, accommodation only, and guaranteed fixed prices. Non-member must pay a higher casual rate, which can change without notice. Deals and discounts on transport and activities if booked through our website. So remember, registration is free. There are no hidden fees or commissions. However, there is a $20 processing fee for replacement of a stolen or lost card. Booking Holiday BPA can assist you with this. We can advise you on travel insurance, what to pack, and what to expect. We can also help you find out a work close to the hostel of your choice by setting up interviews with local employers. We'll also arrange for you to attend at least one social event where you can meet fellow travelers and some of the residents from the same area. Now let us answer. So we have to find out whether it is true, false, or not given. The BPA hostels are managed by independent owners. This is false because it is state-owned. You can find BPA hostels in many different environments. This is true. This is given. BPA hostels have the cheapest accommodation anywhere in the state. 3 is also true. Online bookings are more popular than telephone bookings. 4, this is not given. BPA members who frequently use the hostels pay less than the normal fee. 5, this is exactly true. There is an initial $20 registration fee. 6th, this is false. And local employers prefer to hire casual employees through BPA. 7, this is actually not given. Then, in the next series of questions, this is the content. Let us read it. Applying for a driver's license. Personal vehicle licenses. All applicants will have to show two forms of identification and pass an eye exam. There also is a compulsory driving course, the cost of which must be borne by the driver. And special licenses of this class include, first is provisional license. From age 16 to 18, drivers on this license are subject to several restrictions. Driver must not drive after 8 p.m. and are required to have fully licensed adult in the car at all times. The driver may apply to transfer to a full license after attaining 18 years of age, provided he or she has a clean record. Then motorcycle license. An optional extension course on defensive driving is recommended for drivers with this type of license. This can reduce insurance premiums. Not all motorized two-wheel vehicles classify as motorcycles. Scooters, for example, do not require this license. But note that these vehicles are restricted from riding on main roads and highways. Then we have commercial licenses. Livery licenses or livery licenses. Anyone planning to use their vehicle or as a taxi or a limousine will require this license. Applicants must have a personal vehicle license, which they must surrender upon receipt of the new license. This license also requires renewal every 2 years. Drivers are required to display a registration plate to indicate that they are legally allowed to accept passengers. Then commercial vehicle licenses. These include city buses, single or coupled, school buses, lorries, single or coupled. Then all licenses for commercial vehicle require a probation period, after which the full license will be issued. Application for such a vehicle license will require proof of training, proof of insurance, and mandatory fee, which can usually be claimed back once employment is found. So now answer these questions from 8 to 14. No more than 2 words can be used. So people who want a personal vehicle license must pay for a driving course. First of all, driving course, DC. A teenager must have a dash to get a full license at 18 years old. 9 is clean record. Motorcycle drivers who attend a special class can get a discount of their insurance premiums. People who ride dash on back roads or off-road do not need a license. This is scooters. People who drive a dash or dash need a livery license, that is a taxi or a limousine. Anyone who charges money for driving people in a private car must show a special registration plate that they can accept passengers. 14 is commercial driver have to wait for a dash to get their full license. Probation period. Okay, now from next series of questions, this is the content on which these questions are based. So, becoming an employer. Running a small business is a rewarding but challenging endeavor. And one of the most challenges, major challenges, is hiring staff once your business starts to grow. What kind of people would suit your business needs? You need to evaluate the typical workload your business operates under and whether this work is steady. Permanent staff can be employed full or part-time, but you need to ensure that there is ongoing work into the foreseeable future and that your business can take on the further cost of entitlement such as sick leave, annual leave, and parental leave. As an employer, you'll be legally required to provide these, as well as health and safety training. You'll need to specify their hours of work, wages, and details of their role in advance, and prepare a contract for both parties to sign. Your business may not be ready to take on such a long-term possibility, especially if you only require help during big projects or holiday rushes. In this case, you might consider hiring a fixed-term employee. Remember though that after a certain number of fixed term contracts with the same employee, the law requires you to make the position permanent. If you're not sure how long the term of employment will be, construct the contract carefully to ensure you can terminate the employee at any time, allowing the legally required 2 weeks notice, of course. Alternatively, you could take on a casual worker who can be employed on an ad hoc basis, covering just the days that you cannot manage and own. Though you will need to offer a higher hourly rate called casual loading to compensate for the lack of regularity. If your current budget does not permit hiring another member of staff, you could consider using an intern. However, interns are not just a source of free labor. You must be able to provide experience that benefits them in some way, such as by learning a new skill. Agreements of this sort can legally extend to 12 months, but while you will have to stipulate the duration of the internship, the intern themselves are permitted to resign at any time without giving notice. All workers must be given a contract, no matter whether they are permanent, fixed term, casual, or even interns. Now look at the following statements and the list of employees type below. These are the employee types, and we need to match them. So first is, one more thing is that you have to match each statement and write the correct letter in the answer sheet, but we are going to match here itself. So they cannot work for more than 1 year. Who are these? These are interns. They get a paid holiday every year. These are permanent employees. They can leave without warning. These are again interns. You can finish their contract early if you give warning. 18. This is fixed term employees. They usually get higher wages. These are 19 is C, casual employees, and this kind of employee is best for seasonal work. 20, and these are our fixed term employees. Then from 15 to 27, we have section 2, but we'll jump to 21 to 27. So the text have 7 sections A to G. We need to choose the correct heading for each section from the list of heading below. These are the list of heading, and these are the sections. These are office policies or office politics actually. Office politics Concern, differences that arise between employees. Difference of opinion and conflicts of interest. Good communication is the best way to deal with office politics. A natural reaction to dispute at work is to defend yourself and fight for what you want. But the typical response to that stance is resistance, which achieves nothing. However, if you flee from conflict and don't take a stand, you will be seen as a pushover. Although both fight and flight are instinctive reactions, it is best not to be impulsive but rather to carefully consider how you feel and decide how you will react. Now the B is, there is a temptation to focus on differences of employees' positions and opinions, but try to concentrate on business objectives instead and discuss the problem with these in mind. After all, everyone wants to work for a successful company, so put petty disagreements aside and look at the big picture. C. Sometimes issues arise which workers have little control over, for example, company policies, customer demands or directives from management. It is easy to get caught up in an endless round of complaint, but this rarely, if ever, solves these outside problems. Be realistic about what you can actually influence at work, but don't put your focus on insoluble problems. Then occasionally you'll find yourself caught between two powerful individuals in contention. Do not get drawn into the conflict by supporting one or the other. Remain neutral and objective, and try to keep the discussion focused on the interest of the organization. And when office politics erupt, avoid angry outbursts and never direct your rage towards a particular person. This will only provoke negative feelings towards you, possibly harming your chances of advancement or promotion later. Then if you try to identify and comprehend the position of other parties first, you will gain their trust and open up communication because they will feel less defensive. Using this technique will facilitate a swifter solution to the problem. Then we have G. People don't like to lose. It is humiliating. Outcomes of a conflict at work where there is a loser and a winner are generally not beneficial for either the individual involved or for the company. So it is better to find a resolution which is acceptable to both parties. It is better to have allies than enemies. So before going to section 2, let us answer these. We have to see and find out that these headings are suitable for which sections. So the first one is, don't waste energy on things you can't change. This is 21. And this is our 21 is section A. We'll try to link this section A with this one, 8th one, or 21 would be the 8th one, that is realize you have a choice. And 22 would be our 5th, know what is best for business. 23 would be the first one, that is don't waste energy on things you can't change. 24 will link to 7th, that is don't take sides, be neutral and objective and rational. 25 is our 10th, don't get personal because it will make you or you know the other person will think bad of you and you'll be his enemy. 26 will be 3rd, understand before being understood. Then you have 27, that will be our think win-win because nobody wants to be a loser, so have or present or try to resolve with a win-win situation. Okay, we have completed this. Now coming to section 3, shark deterrent wetsuits. The word shark attack strike fears in beachgoers, surfers, swimmers, divers and others who enjoy the depth in the ocean. After 7 people died from fatal attacks off the coast of Western Australia between 2010 to 2013, the state government reacted by capturing and shooting large sharks of the great white, tiger and bull varieties near swimming beaches. This shark culling policy caused an outcry amongst the environmentalists. B. The existence of this white shark is already threatened and it is at a vulnerable status at high risk of becoming an endangered species. For this reason, it is fully protected in some countries, but the WA, that is Western Australia government, had the species made exempt from the protection in Australia despite there being no scientific evidence to suggest an increase in white shark numbers. C. Sharks are apex predators, key to maintaining the balance of prey population by removing sick or weak individuals and regulating the well-being of the marine ecosystem. They are very slow to reproduce, and with about 100 million sharks being killed every year as a result of fishing and hunting, the global population has been reduced by more than 70% in the last 20 years. The WA government policy of killing large sharks takes out the mature breeding stocks of the species, hastening their eventual extinction. Now, protesters argue that culling is extreme and unnecessary because the actual risk of death by shark is very slim, and the practice of tagging sharks and equipping them with transmitters is enough to alert swimmers when sharks are near. When a tag shark comes within 1 kilometer of a beach, it tweets a message via the Surf Life Saving WA Twitter feed, giving its type, example, bull shark, location, date and time. Now, scientists at Shark Attack Mitigation Service, SAMS, is in collaboration with the Oceans Institute at the University of Western Australia, have come up with a novel and pragmatic solution to the shark problem, a shark deterrent wetsuit. The good news is that it is simple, affordable, and the technology can also be applied to surf boats. The scientific breakthrough came about after observation of how other species protect themselves from shark attacks. In this research, particular attention was given to the pilot fish, which has a mutualistic association with the sharks, swimming alongside them, devouring their harmful parasites and keeping them clean. The pilot fish are relatively small, about 30 to 60 centimeter, and are easily recognized by their patterning. This consists of 5 to 7 transverse bands of darker color than the rest of the body, which is dark blue or blackish silver. These bands are also seen on the poisonous banded sea snake. Folklore claims that some Pacific island tribes used to paint themselves in bands to simulate the appearance of the snake and thus to ward off the shark gods. It is known that sharks use a range of sensors when they prepare for attack, but apparently the sight sensor is what they use to identify their target, especially when they get close up. Experts in shark vision and shark neurology confirm that sharks see in black and white or grayscale. The SAMS scientists, in collaboration with others, they map the physical characteristics of the eyes of 3 main predatory sharks genetically and anatomically. Next, they use complex computer modeling to figure out what the shark's eye could see at different depths and distances and in different light situations and water clarity conditions. From that, they were able to identify that patterns and shapes would essentially hide a potential target or at least create confusion for the shark, and what patterns and shape might break up the profile of a person so that he was not mistaken for shark's prey. Finally, once the science was converted into practical wetsuit design, 2 ideas emerged. The first model, using the bending concept, presents a highly disruptive profile to the shark and depicts the wearer as dangerous and unpalatable. This one is suitable for swimmers, surfers on a surface where they would otherwise provide a tempting backlit silhouette. The second model, the cryptic wetsuits, consists of 3 panels on the suit, one or more matching the reflective spectra of the water and other creating a confusing profile. So this one is better suited to scuba enthusiasts, making them virtually indiscernible in the water column. So it was very difficult to test these wetsuits because of obvious reasons. The researcher could not use humans or even humanoids shaped as bait. Therefore, they wrapped perforated drums full of bait in the newly designed neoprene skins and used underwater cameras to watch how the sharks interacted with the prototype. As a control model, they used a rig wrapped in plain black neoprene, just like a normal wetsuit. Then they were able to record a tiger shark circling and hunting the test rig for 6 minutes, trying to find what it could smell and sense but not see. But the shark gave up and ripped into the control rig as soon as it encountered it. They watched a great white shark encounter a control rig, go to the bottom, then come straight up and strike it, where it was more apprehensive and reluctant to go for the test rig. It is hoped that this shark deterrent design, by disrupting the shark visual perception, will protect swimmers either by deterring attack or at least delaying it sufficiently to allow the user time to get out of the water. So we have 9 paragraphs in all, and we have to find out which paragraph contains these information. And we'll start at 28. And you may also use any letter more than once. So an example of water sport equipment that can use the new wetsuit design 28 is E. D Details of trials carried out on the new wetsuits, that was in the last but one, that is H. Findings of scientists investigating sharks' perception, this was before that F. How beachgoers can be warned for the presence of sharks, 31, that was with a Twitter message or some, you know, signal. Then the importance of shark in keeping fish stocks healthy, 32, that was in D again, or C, it was C, just before D. Statistics that triggered a shark killing response, 33 would be A in the first one, because there was a public outcry. The relationship between sharks and a different sea species, 34, that is E. They are natural predators. How the new wetsuits work as shark deterrent, 35, that was given in the G paragraph. And an explanation of why sharks are in danger of extinction was in C. Then true, false and not given. A deep sea diver wearing a cryptic wetsuit is almost invisible to shark, 37, this is true. He is indiscernible. 38, sharks do not regard banded wetsuits as good to eat. 38, this is also true. Tiger shark waited before attacking the control rig. 39, this is false, because after waiting for some time and trying to find out whether this prey is good to eat, the tiger shark left. Great white shark have more confidence than tiger shark. This is not given. Okay, this was our general training reading practice test 5. Thank you so much. Take care.